Hello, welcome to Let's Play Workbench, the Amiga Workbench, yay! Hello, this is the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Play Amberstar, and I just want to say a bunch of things here. I don't know, 1992, this game was released kind of like a cross between a dungeon crawler and like people liken it to like Ultima 7. Not sure. I mean, that's a lot to live up to, Ultima 7. I mean, I haven't played that one, but I've heard a lot of great things about it. Anyway, here's all the Amber discs, right? So I'm playing on the FS-UAE emulator. So the reason why my mouse is so slow, because during the game, it flies all over the place with the slightest movement of the mouse. So I have it, believe it or not, the mouse acceleration down to 5%. 5%. I had to keep lowering it. Nope, gotta lower it some more. So we got it. I had trouble getting this game to run. I had trouble with the mouse speed. I can't record this in a full screen. So I'm in a window, but obviously you can't see the window. I'm not recording that part. So recording with Bandicam, by the way. So the way this game is, most of it you're going to see, as I'll explain as I go along. Now this is a blind Let's Play, but I have read the manual. RTFM people, read the manual, and read the blank manual. There's not too much, there's a lot of information left out of the manual. I'm not sure if that's on purpose or not. There is like this long story, like a novelette, I'm not even sure where it falls into. I don't know how many words it is. It took me a while to read it. I was in the middle of other things, but it took me a good while to read it. Pretty good story. I think it's really well done, so if I remember, I'll put a link to the Thalion Web Shrine has the manual up there and a walkthrough. Now, I read the beginning of a walkthrough and stopped once they started giving away, okay, go here, go there, because there's a lot of stuff left out of the manual. Like, for instance, the skills and the stats and everything like that. Like, what are they, standard D&D stats or what? I didn't even know. So, because this is not Dungeons and Dragons, so this is its own system, so. But it seems to be following D&D pretty much. And what else? I'll be putting this series up on Saturdays and Sundays, at least for the near future. So there's that, and my weekly series will continue as they have been. Eventually, I don't know, I might branch it out into daily or something like that, I don't know, because otherwise it's going to take me a while to get through, and I guess that's okay. But I've been wanting to play this for a while, and I've been wanting to play a lot of things for a while, but no, we're going to play this. So this, when you install this game, kind of reminds me of Starflight. For anyone familiar, the Starflight discs, you can't play off the original discs because it overwrites itself. It doesn't make a separate save file, it overwrites the game files themselves. So the game files change as you play. So you really only want to play with a copy. So this is an install of on a virtual hard drive here of Amberstar. And we're not going to play through here just yet because this is my test character. So what we want to do is go to Amberstar A. And we want to go Amber install. Now, of course, I'm going to take out all the waiting and such like that. And at least I'm not talking about stuff. So when you go to install, you get this. And yes, the Amiga drives really sounded like that back then. This is an emulated sound. It's pretty freaking awesome how they do that. So here, we create our character. And once we create our character, once we hit OK, then it starts to install. Interesting, huh? So you can either install it on a bunch of floppies, basically copy the floppies that, the original ones, or is to install it on the hard drive, which is much preferable, in my opinion. So I'm going to go female. None of the females are particularly attractive or anything like that, but I guess I like the hair here. They don't have a redhead. The others look kind of dreadful or androgynous, like that cloaked one. So here, female, name. Oops. Amethyst. That's the easy part. Now, unfortunately, there's no point system. I like the point system. You can plus and minus off of where you want to. Not like this. We got to roll over and over again. So, attributes, strength. I think that applies to fighters. I had to look up something on a message board where somebody else was writing about what these stats exactly, what they affect in the game. And he was even guessing with some of these things. It's not even in the walkthrough on the Thalion website. It is not listed in the manual. I don't know why. So strength, probably good for warriors, and it affects how much you can carry. Intelligence gives you more spell points in which you can cast spells. Dexterity, he was guessing that it might be good for disarming traps, I believe he says. Speed, that's a different one. Speed affects your initiative in battle. Who gets to go first? I haven't even been in a battle yet, so I don't know what kind of battle this is. I know it's turn-based, but I don't know if it's, you know, if it can be, you know, party member, foe, party member, party member, foe, foe, or if it's all the party members and all the foes. Go. I don't even know. So, constitution affects how many hit points you get every level. Charisma affects your buying things at the merchants. I mean, this might be other stuff as well. Luck, I guess, improves you to hit randomly. This, from what I've seen, is not magic, but it's magic resistance. No matter what, we're at zero, no matter how many times you roll this. Now, skills, this is attack. Guessing at some of this. Parry, swim, listen. I think this is find traps, disarm traps. Correct me here if I'm wrong, guys, and if you know something else. Pick lock. I think this is search. RMS. I have no freaking clue what that is. RMS. Really don't know. And U/M might have something to do with magic? I don't even know. So even this, when you roll, this is your gold. So we can start with 50 gold and 5 rations. Now when you roll, even this stat changes. So this is not really that good, because I'm going to make a mage, and I'm really leaning towards black mage at this time. White mage is basically, this is kind of like similar to the old Final Fantasy games. White mage is healing and stuff such like that, and, you know, curing poison, all of that. Whatever, what have you. Basically restoring you back to a healthy state is mostly white wizard. Gray wizard is, for the most part, from what I can see, buffs. Buffs, maybe debuffs on the enemy. Not sure about that. And the black wizard is all offensive spells. Fireball, lightning bolt, you know, cloud of doom, whatever. That's not an actual spell name. So I'm leaning towards that. The only thing, you can only make a human in this game, unfortunately. So, and from what I can see, you choose your guild as you play the game. So I'd have to find the Black Wizard's guild unless I change my mind or something like that. I'm really leaning towards Black Wizard. But anyway, obviously you want to make a good character for this. So, intelligence, of course, is important. Speed is just important in general. You want to go before the enemy. Constitution gives you extra hit points, which is good for a wizard. Not sure. magic resistance we cannot increase. So really, I'm looking at intelligence, speed, and con. Now, in D&D, regular D&D, well, that's agility, isn't it? We don't have agility, do we? It's agility in D&D that gives you, you know, a little bonus to your AC, which is good for characters that cannot wear armor. We don't have agility. Maybe speed? Not sure if that affects your AC, though. I can't really say. From what I've seen, I haven't seen anything pointing towards that. So intelligence is 30. It's no good. We've got everything basically 30. Except for luck. So we roll. And that's even worse. And as you can see, our gold and rations change as well. Oh my god, intelligence 9. So really, I'm just going to roll. I'm just going to see intelligence 49. That's pretty good. Look at one ration, though. 19 gold. I don't know if it's possible to get really good in all the skills you want. As you can see, magic resistance here, at least that's what it stands for, is not increasing. Luck is pretty good. Con is stinky. Look at the speed, though. 60 out of 60? Is this a good roll? Should I save this? We can't save our roll, like in stuff like in games like Baldur's Gate. So I'm only going to oh my god, 9 strength. I'm only going to subject you guys to a little bit of this. Because this is boring as hell. So basically I'm going for a good intelligence and then, wow, dexterity 9. If it wasn't for dexterity like that, I would go for this. I would. But nope. And I heard this game is tough. The only thing is there's one save game. There's one save game, so if you save in a bad area, get yourself an unwinnable situation, there's dungeons you can get stuck in, and be very hard or impossible to find your way out, because they're basically locked behind you until you get to a certain point and unlock it or something like that. Or you have to come out a different way. You're screwed. So I'm going to be, for the most part, I'm using save states. I think I have 9 or 10 slots, something like that. I hope it's 10, because 9's stupid amount. Wow, charisma 3. Okay, 49 out of 60. Dexterity. Speed. Look at that luck, though. 2 gold. I don't think this really changes. I'm going to try to push it. I want intelligence a little bit higher. Oh, and charisma's horrible. So I'm looking intelligence. 55. Strength. Luck is bad. It's a lot of gold, though. 56. Dexterity 6. Yeah, I don't really want 0 zeros. Fifty-2 out of 60. Speed bad. Charisma 5. My God. Look at that. Speed 60. I want intelligence higher though. Oh my God. Intelligence 1. Can you imagine? So I don't know if this is completely random or if it's just a certain amount of points and you can't go over it. So one is going to suck no matter what. Intelligence 1 again. 58 out of 60. But look at that. Speed and con are horrible. Luck is horrible. But could be because these are so high. Well, it's not bad, is it? 52 out of 60, 41. Strength 53, intelligence 52, dexterity 41. speed 29, con 51, charisma 34, luck is 25. Now, from what I understand, a lot of these skills you can increase. You can find items and stuff to increase it after that. I think we're going to go with this, and we have 8 rations. I'll tell it okay. So it tells me install where. Hope this works. That's the drive hard one. I don't know. So then it tells me it's installing, and I have the other floppies already. I virtually have 4 drives right now. I have the workbench and drive A, and then drives B, C, and D. I have Amberstar A, B, and C. And then I have the hard drive. So this is writing over my test and putting this one in its place. I literally named a character test and did it like that. So the first video of this was just the intro, but you don't see that until after you get to this step. You know what I'm saying? But I always leave the intro and stuff like that for the first video at full volume and everything like that, because that's just the way you do things like that. And yeah, even though it's not much of an intro, it's just a couple splash screens and awesome music with credits. So I had literally took me, I wanted to have this up last weekend, guys, for those who are watching this currently, but it took me literally like a whole day just to get this running. I'm like, okay, now let's figure out how to record it. And then we had to tweak it. The mouse was all over the place. I have volume at 50%. Otherwise, the music's too loud for you to hear me over. I had a memory issue, so I had to increase the memory. I thought it was going to be a problem. Some guys were reporting problems with virtual hard drives over 20 megs not working, but I didn't have that problem. Knock on wood, because this is way over 20 megs. People were telling me something, there was stuff online about disabling the CPU cache, making it 0%. FS-UAE, I couldn't find a way to do that. You can do it in WinUAE, but WinUAE pisses me off sometimes. It really does. It is not very user-friendly. So now we're installing Disk C. Ta-ta-da. So after this is done, you know, then the stuff from the intro, you see that, so I'm going to skip past that, obviously. Now, give me some time, guys, to get used to this, because, well, I'm basically using the numpad on the right side of the keyboard to move around for the most part. You can also click on the screen, but it's really awkward to, like, move your character. You can click to where you want your character to go. Unless it might be handy outside, maybe. Installation complete! So I do have a lot of tips and stuff like that that I've read. I've read the manual. It's just I haven't put all the things in the manual into practice. So it's one thing to read it and then try to memorize what stuff is. Am I supposed to click or something? There you go. Okay, so now it's installed. And then bloop. And it should be overwritten here with my new character. Thalion. Ta-ta-da. Cool image. It'll be a cool desktop, wouldn't it? Awesome music of awesomeness. You can watch part one to hear that. See, I love that song. The theme song. Ta-da! Sadness and pain move you at this moment. Why did it have to be your parents? Why couldn't you have been with them when the band of orcs attacked their coach? Dumbfounded, you look at the grave. What will you do now? Give up everything and go out into the world to seek your fortune? With tears on your face, you turn away from the grave. Your hands in your pockets feel the only thing you have from your mother, a piece of her scarf which lay at the edge of the lane. Apparently, it must have been torn off during the battle with the orcs. With a deep sigh, you leave the grave and go on your way home. Graveyard of Twin Lake, and we are here, so we can move like this. Or we can use... Oh, we can click the arrows. It goes ouch. Or I can use a numpad. Now, the only thing about the numpad is sometimes I press the numpad and nothing happens. There we go. So I'm pressing it. Press, press. Yeah, nothing happened there. Press, press, press. So sometimes I might click it, I don't know. I prefer to move around. You feel it's getting colder. The mist is getting thicker, and an eerie, wailing sound reaches you through the frosty air. Okay. Now, this is primarily mouse-driven, but the way the mouse works, it's just different from the way games nowadays. Like, you use the left mouse and the right mouse for different things. He won't move. The Tomb of Sir Marillion. Oh yeah, he's. They write about him in the intro story in the manual. Now here, if you right-click, you get these options. I don't know if I can read it from here. No, I can't reach. So I have to move. I have to change it back. And move. Move. Alright. This is the statue of Bela, the goddess of death. The statue is made of blackest obsidian, and a tear appears to be trickling down its cheek. You hear nothing! Hello! So basically, this is look at, this is listen, this is talk, this is, I think, to change the order of the party. What formation should group members take up for the next battle? Yeah. Okay. Basically, I'm going to be spellcaster, so I'm going to put myself to the rear, even though there's no one in my party yet. So I don't forget. Alright. I might click around the map, just because it's... The numpad doesn't always work. This is the statue of Gala, the goddess of life. The statue is of the finest white marble, and if you look closely, it seems to smile at you. Just so you know, guys, there are no complete Let's Plays of this game in English at this point. If there are, they're named strange names, or they're not on YouTube. There's... some walkthroughs, basically. There's some Let's Plays in German, and there's some walkthroughs that are basically, you know, just someone playing the game. There's no voice. There's no commentating. I can't even find any reviews of this game. Really? I have to go all the way around. Oh. Yeah, see. Oh, I have to go. There you go. Ouch. The golden letters on this plaque say, "May the water give you refreshment and the force of life." So, pretty much you go here. When you touch the water, you have a feeling that fresh life is flowing through your body. Now that will restore your hit points, possibly your magic points as well, I'm not sure. You are standing before a tomb made of ivory and marble. The following text is engraved in the polished marble. His life was dedicated to light, and his soul will escape from the shadows. Okay, so this one says, the golden letters on this wooden plaque say, "May the water quicken your spirit." So there is one Let's Play in English, 40 parts of, I believe, if I remember correctly. It is in English, and basically it's unfinished. Or if it was ever finished, those videos are no longer there because it was re-uploaded by somebody else, originally put up by Notch Glanz, I believe? Something Knight something in German. She also had Let's Plays in German. When you touch the water, you have a feeling that a magical force is flowing through your mind. So this one, I think, increases your speed. Like a haste or something like that. Now, I know you need torches in this game. I can't take this torch, can I? So you can't do anything. So here is a door. The lock cannot be opened. Find no traps. Basically, we have a key here. But that... Did I use the key? Hold on. I still have it, alright. So here's our stuff. I'm 18 years old. This is, level points, I think? I'm not even sure. Oh no, life points. Life points. These are experience points. Zero, because I haven't done crap. Life points, we have 4 out of 4 hit points at this point. They call them life points. They gotta be different. So this is our, I guess this is our attack and defense. 3 and 2. This is how much we are holding. We can hold up to 53 kilograms. We have 3. That's pretty self-explanatory. Now, those are clothes. See if we can look at stuff. So armor. Any class can wear it. Now we can see the classes we are that are available. Not for us, but that we can encounter and add to our party. Basically, warrior. Paladin, which they call Paladin, I guess, for some reason. Ranger, thief, monk, there's white wizard, gray wizard, black wizard. Gender, both. Basically, this is who can use these clothes. So it gives you 1 tier AC, apparently. Leather shoes, another 1 tier AC. 400 grams? What's it say for? Oh, kilograms. Oh wait, they even go down to grams in this. 1,000 grams. So isn't that 1 kilogram? And then we have this key. House door key. Even the key weighs something. Your gold actually weighs stuff in this game, which stinks. I hate when games do that. It does make it realistic though. And here's the attributes and stuff that I load up, that I rolled up. Blah. What's this do? Oh, this brings you back here. So basically, you have, you know, these are places on your body. Oh, we have a knife. I didn't even realize that. Let's look at the knife. Melee weapon. Hands. One? Does it increase AC for your hands? Is that what that is? Damage 3. Yeah, I'm not even sure. Oh, maybe one hand. It's one-handed. That's what that means. So it's basically it. And then the thing is, a lot of these things, I don't remember. This is moving gold. I think this is distribute gold. This is giving gold to a member. Giving food to a party member. Giving an item to a party member. I think this is distribute, I'm not sure. Not completely sure what this is. I've read this stuff and I just, you know, I'm gonna learn by doing. It's basically what it is. So exit. This is one of the things in the walkthrough I read. You're supposed to wait around. Now I am holding it down. This thing. Nobody's coming, damn it. Oh. All right. We got a ghosty. Ghosty. Let's talk to the ghosty. Sir Marillion. No dialogue, huh? Age 31. Bela, Gala, and Halal. Ah, the pain, the light. Who am I? Wait, Marmion. You will never reach the fortress of God's Bane. Where am I? Keep going, man. Even Bralkar, the Prince of Darkness, cannot stop us if we hold together. What am I doing here? Classic ghost doesn't know what they're dead. That they're dead. Ah, the pain, the light. Indeed. Gala. I can say nothing about that. Why the hell not? Nothing about that. What item would you like to show? I don't want to show anything. Give. Okay, this is. You can actually show people an item. Interesting. Give how much gold? None. Give how many rations? None. Now, I guess there's nothing else we can do. You can enter words as well. Marillion has one R and two L's. You can say nothing about your own self. Okay, for all I know, there's more things, but I'm not aware of them. Let me just try something else. Nope. What's his name? No, Tar. Tarbos. No, you didn't say anything about Tarbos. Tarbos is the character from the game, we've already been running 33 minutes. Tarbos is the character from basically a demon lord fused with a human being. A demon lord fused with a human son of a demon lord. Shrug. Part of the novel at the end of the manual. So, we're gonna... We wait around. I only know this from peeking at the walkthrough. Most of the stuff after this, I don't know, except for just game mechanics. Okay, hello. Really, I'm surprised you can't get a description of people. Gwendolyn! Hello, Gwendolyn. Grey Wizard. Aw, she's crying. What do you want? Can you not leave me in peace, even at my saddest moment, at the grave of my beloved Marillion? Nope. Can't leave you in peace, Marillion. He was a paladin full of goodness and courage, but now he is caught between day and night. Dreadful Marmion, he banned the spirit of my beloved into the realms of the souls, and now he wants to plunge the world into chaos. Oh, if only I had the Rose of Sadness. The Rose of Sadness, really? What about the Rose of Sadness? The Rose of Sadness is the only thing with which I can release Marillion from the Realm of Souls. Only one rose blossoms every 100 years at a place called Sea of Peace, but regrettably I cannot find this place. Hmm. Gala? Say nothing about that. Oh, my keyboard decided to stop working? Why? Did I hit caps lock? I did. I think a keyboard buffer overrid that. Hold on. Nothing about that. Alright. Yeah, I guess that's it. I don't know what else to ask her about. Might just try to ask her about herself. Yeah, I haven't played this far, guys. I just know you were supposed to wait around for her. Gwendolyn. Nope, alright. Now, I don't think this key... I think we just walk into it. I don't think this key unlocks this. The lock cannot be opened. I might be doing this wrong, I'm not sure. I don't think the key is used for that. Basically, I think at this point, I think you put the key in the lock, even though it's not showing on the graphic, and then pressing this will turn it, but that key does not work in that. Again, traps. So that's it. That's it for that, but you can come back to get yourself healed up and get haste or whatever on you. Now to one of my favorite songs, at least so far. This is called Eric's Revenge, and I think it's named after the programmer, I believe, in the game. Because his name is Eric, also spelled E-R-I-K. So I'm going to leave off here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. We actually get somewhere. I go into town and look around. We'll be in 3D perspective at that point, sort of. First-person view. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.